approaching the boxing ring in this men's 60 kilogram lightweight semi-final is the man widely regarded as the best pound for pound amateur boxer in the world, the reigning world champion, the tournament number one seed, the second ranked boxer in the world, an Olympic champion from 4 years ago at 57 kilograms, Vasyl Lomachenko. And his opponent from Cuba is the tournament number four seed, the sixth ranked boxer in the world, the reigning Pan Am Games champion, and that is Yasnier Toledo. And what a contest we have in prospect here, because this is a rematch of the world championship final from Baku, Azerbaijan last year. On that occasion, it was Lomachenko who reigned supreme. And how significant is that contest at that stage in this particular bout, Richie?
Yeah, absolutely crucial. They have the psychological advantage. But Toledo will raise his game. This is the Olympic Games and a place in the final at stake. So this one should be a cracker.
Introducing in the red corner, representing Ukraine, gold medalist at last year's World Championships, Vasyl Lomachenko. And in the blue corner, representing Cuba, silver medalist at that same World Championships, Yasnier Toledo Lopez.
Well, this promises to be an absolutely fascinating encounter between two of the best lightweight boxers in the world, a rematch of last year's World Championship final in Baku, Azerbaijan.
Second out, round one.
So here we go then, the first of a scheduled three-minute rounds in the men's 60-kilogram lightweight division. We are at the semi-final stage of the Olympic boxing tournament. The winner will progress through to the gold medal bout, and it is being contested between the boxer wearing red, operating out of the southpaw stance, the reigning world champion, and that is Vasyl Lomachenko of the Ukraine. His opponent, wearing blue, also boxing out of the southpaw stance, representing Cuba, is Yasnier Toledo, the world championship silver medalist, having come up short against Lomachenko in that final last year.
Well, we can see straight away that the Cubans have told their man to try and box at range and keep Lomachenko on the outside. That was a good exchange there, because Lomachenko is fast with the feet. He lands blistering combinations to the body, and then he finishes with that right up to the head. So what Toledo's trying to do is not let him in at that situation. He's got to keep it mid along, quite plain to see.
Both boxers received byes by virtue of being seeded. Lomachenko is the number one seed. Toledo is the number four seed in the tournament. And in the two contests that Lomachenko has boxed to date, he has barely got out of second gear. He doesn't sit down between rounds. His breath hasn't become noticeably heavier, and he really hasn't had to dig deep or even use his full repertoire of skills.
Yeah, ring position here, crucial for Toledo. Got to stay centre ring. This Lomachenko, his movement is superb. In, out, side to side. You can really do it all, this fella in red. But allow him on the inside and you've got real problems. So you best stay in the centre of the ring.
Working really effectively to the body throughout the course of this round so far is Lomachenko. Good left hand beneath the elbow there. And in those two contests that Lomachenko has boxed in, 15-3 he prevailed over the Wellington Arias from Dominican Republic, 14-9 over Puerto Rico's Felix Verdeo. Been two contests as well for Toledo, 14-10 over the man from China, Liu Qiang. And then he eliminated the number five seed in what was a cracking contest, but he prevailed by 19-11 over Kazakhstan's Gaini Zhailov. Good right hand to the body from Toledo.
Yeah, occasionally Lomachenko has a lapse in concentration, holds his feet as he did there and gets caught. If he decides to hold his feet, that'll bring Toledo into it a little bit more. He'll be able to work with his jab. But if he keeps them feet moving side to side, as I've said before, then Toledo will have problems. So Toledo's got to try and slow his man's feet down a little bit and concentrate on straight shots.
Two of the great boxing nations in the amateur boxing world. And at the end of the first round, there is nothing to separate them. It is tied at 3 points apiece. after one round of boxing.
I'm not going to disagree with that, but you just get the feeling this man was just literally warming up. Doesn't even bother to sit down. Lovely work there, little slip to his left, and then he comes back with that left-hand counter. Toledo did have some success to the body with the right hand, and very quickly gets his guard back up again. Well, I think this is where he should be working more. He's at range, and then switch. Lovely right up to the body there. That was his best shot of the round.
Psychological games even taking place in the corner, neither man electing to sit down, neither man wanting to show that they're feeling the pace, standing up, receiving the instructions ahead of this second round. Two boxers who know one another so very well. They met in a gold medal bout in the World Championships last year. Here in London 2012, it is a stage earlier, we're at the semi-final stage in the men's 60 kilogram lightweight division between two highly skilled exponents. And it's the man in red, Vasyl Lomachenko, widely regarded as the best pound for pound amateur boxer in the world, as Toledo got through with a good left hand, against the man he defeated in the World Championship final, Yasnier Toledo. And this promises to be a bout that is living up to expectation.
Lomachenko really is getting to grips with this now. He's on the front foot. A slight change in tempo and tactic from him. His movement's coming forward, but he's managing to close that gap down. Now Toledo's got to respond here. Got to try and either work with him or break away and create a bit of space and bring him onto a shot. Shouldn't be standing there. That's bad.
Lomachenko working away with real effectiveness to the body. Stand by the referee for illegal use of the shoulder, pushing his man off with it. Now Toledo back at centre ring, trying to score with that left cross out of the southpaw stance, but Lomachenko blocked it effectively. And after beginning a round on the front foot, Lomachenko just remaining out of punching range and circling the ring perimeter.
Yeah, timing and accuracy is crucial here from Toledo. He's got to try and bring Lomachenko onto that straight left, but he can't afford to allow him on the inside like that. As soon as he comes into punching range, the Cuban has got to punch long. He's electing to put rather at mid-range, and that's allowing Lomachenko just in on the inside with those fast hands.
And just over half the round has gone by already, and it has been a much better round to this point for Vasyl Lomachenko. The score was tied at 3 points apiece after the opening round of boxing. And then Lomachenko, after just taking a look and remaining out of punching range for a clear portion of the round, is now back onto the front foot once more and just threatening to overwhelm Toledo. So we're inside the final minute of this second round. And it's been clusters of punches. Toledo did get through with a good right hand to the body.
Oh, lovely there from Lomachenko.
Blistering hand speed as he worked away to the body of Toledo. Toledo hasn't been able to launch any sustained attacks of his own. He's trying to pot shot with that left hand, but all too often it's been blocked by the gloves of Lomachenko.
Well, that wasn't too bad from Toledo there, but he's got to punch straighter and longer. He's allowing his man in on the inside. He's nicking the odd shot. That blistering hand speed, but really it needs an adjustment of the feet from Toledo, and then punch long.
So the bell sounds, and what was a tied contest at the end of the first round has turned into a 2 points advantage for Lomachenko at the end of two rounds of boxing. 9-7 in Lomachenko's favour.
Yeah, just that change in tempo halfway through the round from Lomachenko. Gets caught there after slipping a good shot, Lomachenko, but it changed the tempo during that round. Really up the work rate, and that caught Toledo off guard a little bit. And that hand speed in on the inside is crucial. There's one punch at least getting through there. Timing and distance is the key for this man. And they know it.
Plenty of encouragement for Toledo as he enters his third and final round, trailing by two. So into the third and final round we go of this men's 60-kilogram lightweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, representing Ukraine, Vasyl Lomachenko, and his opponent from Cuba, wearing blue, Yasnier Toledo. Cuba have a terrific tradition in all of Olympic boxing, of course, but in this weight category in particular. Mario Kindelan was a two-time champion in Sydney and Athens 2004. Angel Herrera in Moscow 1980. And if Toledo wants to join their rank, he's going to have to return a two-point deficit against the reigning world champion, a man who got the better of him at the World Championships in Baku, Azerbaijan last year. And that is Vasyl Lomachenko.
I think Toledo's landing with a couple of good right hooks to the body here. Lomachenko just stepped back a little bit and had a bit of a break, but what Toledo should do now, after landing that right hook to the body, should switch it to the head. So it's a right hook to the body, right hook to the head, maybe finish on either a left uppercut or a straight left.
Lomachenko's record in senior international competition is absolutely remarkable. Two-time World Championship gold medalist in 2009 and 2011. 2008 European champion as well. Gold medalist in Valbarka, trophy winner from Beijing 2008. The last time he lost in a major competition was the 2007 World Championships, where he came away with this silver. Really has been a remarkable run. And it just demonstrates that in addition to his outrageous talent, he's backed up by a serious work ethic and plenty of determination.
Yeah, just before this sequence here, Lomachenko, I think he's feeling the pace a little bit. He's been caught with a couple of body shots. Look, he's just backing off.
Good body shot again from Toledo.
Yeah, better work from the Cuban. And what the Cuban's got to do now, Ronald, with those straight 1-2s and then step back. Lomachenko always comes forward. That's better.
Good combination once more from Toledo, and what was a two-point advantage could just be being eaten into by Toledo. He is desperate to book his place in that gold medal bout. Remember, Cuba came away from the Olympic Games 4 years ago with 8 medals, but none of them gold. The first time since 1968 that in Olympic Games where they've entered, they haven't come away with a gold medal.
Toledo's got to jump on this man here now. Lomachenko's feeling the pace a little bit. He's running, he thinks he's won. He's holding on longer on the, in the clinches. These are all signs that Toledo should pick up, and he should try and force Lomachenko off and start to work more, this Cuban.
These final 20 seconds are going to be absolutely crucial. Lomachenko led by 2 coming into this third and final round, but it has been a brilliant round of boxing from Toledo, who is on the front foot once more. The momentum perhaps just tilting slightly in his favour, and again, Lomachenko content and keen to hold on in centre ring as the seconds elapse in this third and final round of this semi-final. Toledo continuing to work away, got through the cracking right hand to the body. It was a good right hand response from Lomachenko, and the two familiar rivals, the World Championship gold medalist and World Championship silver medalist, produced a contest of the highest quality in this Olympic semi-final. Fantastic stuff. And the verdict, well, it hangs in the balance and will be determined by the 5 judges ringside.
Yeah, I get the impression Lomachenko thinks he's won this contest, but I think it's a lot closer than what some people think. It was a good round for Toledo. Worked well there with that right up to the body, sorry, right up to the head. But his right up to the body in particular was worked very well in that last round. I think it's closer than what both the boxers think.
Crucial moments now. Both boxers anxiously awaiting the announcement of the verdict to see who will progress through to the Olympic gold medal bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 14 points to 11 in the red corner, representing Ukraine, Vasyl Lomachenko.
So it is a return to an Olympic final for Vasyl Lomachenko, the reigning world champion, has prevailed over his arch rival from Cuba, the man he beat in the World Championship final in Baku, Azerbaijan last year. He has repeated the victory. Toledo, unable to secure revenge, But what a high quality contest that was. Lomachenko given the last round by a score of 5-4, and he books his place in his second Olympic final in succession. This time it's at the 60 kilogram lightweight division. The Cuban corner can't believe it, but their man, and he exits the tournament at the semi-final stage. It will be a bronze medal for Toledo.